Today we are gonna see whether this guy is worth buying or not. Hey guys, I'm Kishore and welcome to my channel. That's 2020 quarantine and you guys working from home. Survey says that workload has increased significantly. Nah, I'm just kidding. I just asked a few friends around and surprisingly every single one of them said the same thing. Coincidence? I think not. Besides coping up with those piled up tickets assigned to you and hitting that alt tab whenever someone pings randomly, it can be distracting, or when you had to explain the values in the spreadsheet on a Zoom call with your boss that you received 5 minutes ago, it could be frustrating. It's not too late to throw in that old PC monitor lying around as a second screen so that whenever someone pings useless message, you could just glance over and update your boss with the details on time and get that appreciation. Without further ado, let's find out whether this is worth buying or not. So here's the package I received on Amazon. The seller shipped it right away and I got it a day later. I chose this seller because he had 1500 ratings with 3.5 stars and most recent positive reviews, and the price was kind of modest compared to others who had 0 reviews, which is kind of sus, or good reviews but without audio feed. So the price was about 350 rupees or $4.5, and the box looks kind of sturdy enough to avoid damage to the product during the transit. But I wish they had written Pi on the box, because PiBOX, get it? And here's the adapter with audio cable. If we learned anything in 2020, it is to wear a mask and sanitize the Amazon packages. So if you are impatient like me, so better sanitize the product before using it, or if you can wait, keep it aside for a week or so and then unpack it. So I am using a soap solution on a cloth to clean the products, avoiding the terminals, and make sure it completely dries before you actually use it so that you don't short anything. Here's the VGA cable from my monitor. See that the pins align and plug it firmly. Also, important thing to notice, this converter supports 1080p at 60Hz. So if you have higher resolution monitor or TV like 4K, you would either experience a drop in refresh rates or it might completely reject the input. So keep that in mind. It should work with most monitors. Here is the AUX port, or you might call it audio jack, which connects to the external speakers or stereo. And here's the cable from my speaker. And yeah, make sure to plug it firmly as well. So let me turn on my second screen and plug the HDMI cable. As always, remember to plug it as firmly as possible, because if you don't, from what I experienced, even a slight movement in the laptop can really affect the display, which you'll see in a moment. Yeah. Now it's basically mirroring my screen, and if you are using Windows 10, go to Notifications panel, click on Project and choose Extend Display. Now it's working, but something is off. Okay, so my computer thinks that the second screen is on the right side of the laptop. Let me show you by opening a window. So if I move the window towards the right, it pops up on the left, which shouldn't be happening, but it's a problem which can be fixed in no time. In Windows, right click and go to display settings, and as you can see, the second monitor is configured to be on the right side of the first monitor. You can change that by just clicking and dragging around and wherever your actual monitor is and hit apply. So that should have fixed it. Let's check it out. So if I move the window towards left, it seems to be working, but still the text seems kind of blown up on the left side, which is a resolution problem. As you can see, the second monitor looks smaller than the first monitor. So to fix that, just click on the second monitor and change the resolution, which on my case is 1080p, and hit keep changes. So now the text seems a bit smaller and the difference seems so much better now. Now let's check the audio quality of the adapter. But before that, I have connected my speakers directly to my laptop so that you will kind of get a sense of what it actually sounds like. Set it to full volume and play.
A binary search tree, to be clear. What's an upper bound on the running time?
So it's about that level. Now I'm connecting the speakers to the AUX port in the adapter. And playing the same video.
8 over there, because if you keep doing that, putting smaller and smaller numbers or bigger and bigger numbers, you can imagine your tree getting very lanky.
As you can hear, it sounds about the same, which is a good thing.
It's balanced as the tree we drew. And so it turns out there are algorithms that let you keep a binary search tree balanced. So even as you add elements to it, you kind of shift things around.
Setup like this can be very useful to follow along coding classes or online lectures without missing out on the video or constantly switching back between the screens.
Dynamism, the ability to grow and if we want shrink, but we sacrifice binary search. But if we spend a little more space and use not one pointer for every node but two, we can actually tip the scales again, spend more space, and save time by searching the data structure, this time using something logarithmic. All right, so what would the ideal, though, be? Every time we talk about running time...
Now to give a little bit more idea about the speakers I use, here's what my inbuilt laptop speaker sounds like, which was actually good enough for my daily use, but here it sounds so low.
To a data
that gave us constant time. Like, my God, if we could just insert something into a data structure with one step and find something in a data structure.
So yeah, I would totally recommend buying it. It works seamlessly with most of the day-to-day application. I even tried it with CAD modeling software and edited half of this video with the second screen, and it works seamlessly. And if you want to buy the exact same model, link is in the description below, and the one without the audio feature is also in the description, where you can save about $1. And yeah, that's my review about the VGA to HDMI adapter. If this video sucked, you know what to do. Else give it a thumbs up and subscribe. That would help the channel a lot. So yeah, see you guys in the next one.